the Ka Nying Shedrip Ling Monastery. A stifling and gloomy place. Those who will be participating in this ceremony are young priests. They are still only children. And they will spend their lives in the monastery. Their days will be spent in hunger and poverty. They will not work, and they will beg for food. They will have no family lives, and they will have nothing to wear but these clothes. And what is more, they will do all this in the name of a superstitious belief, in order not to be reborn as a fly or a mouse. Because they believe in a religion that is full of superstition and error, Buddhism. Buddhism is such an enormous error that it regards people torturing themselves as a virtue. People cut themselves off from life in the name of myth and superstition. For Buddhists, who spend their days in pointless, irrational rituals, life is always dark and stagnant. Furthermore, amongst all these rituals, Buddhism causes people to forget God, or even to deny Him. Islam, on the other hand, totally opposes this distorted mentality. It offers people a rational, restorative, and dynamic life. Quite unlike Buddhists, those who live by the moral values of Islam are always productive, happy, and at peace. And most important of all, those who live by the moral values of Islam draw close to God, the Lord of all creation, and gain the greatest happiness possible for human beings, the good pleasure of God. This film portrays the religion of Buddhism and its irrational practices. Those who regard Buddhism as a road to peace and contentment as a result of deceptive propaganda should pay close attention to the truths described in this film. In the 6th century BC, India was under the occupation of the Aryans. The dominant religion in the country was that of the Aryans, Brahmanism. The Aryans implemented a strict caste system in the country. Under that caste system, society was divided into different groups. Brahmin priests were at the top of the system and ruthlessly oppressed the people. During those years, a son was born to Prince Suddhodana, a member of the noble Sakya family, Siddhartha Gautama. Siddhartha spent his youth in ease and plenty. When he reached the age of 29, however, he left the palace he was living in and turned to a mystical quest, as a result of which he set out certain principles. These principles gradually turned into a teaching, Buddhism. Buddhism arose in northeast India. In time, it extended throughout Sri Lanka, Burma, Thailand, Laos, Cambodia, China, Tibet, Mongolia, Manchuria, Korea, and Nepal. Today, it has about 330 million followers. The word Buddha means the awakened or enlightened one, signifying the spiritual heights that Siddhartha Gautama is supposed to have attained. And Siddhartha is remembered by that name. Buddha chose to speak about his basic tenets and hand on his form of worship orally. The teachings of Buddha were handed on from generation to generation, in oral form only, for 400 years. This teaching was then collected in a book called Pali Canon. The text regarded as sacred by Buddhism today is the Tipitaka, which contains many crass errors. This text was written in the Pali language. Buddhist priests perform their ceremonies and organize their lives according to this text. The only subject matter in these books is people suppressing all their desires and trying to train their souls by living lives full of poverty and suffering. Buddhists have so concentrated on those matters that they are totally unaware of a far more important truth. That truth is the existence of God.